Game, begin.
The Minimax algorithm is a classic of AI research. The first task is to represent the problem. Ask yourself how your own brain represents something like a game of Go. Standard AI search algorithms incorporate heuristic knowledge. Greedy search, uniform cost, A-star, all work like this. In a game, we also want to know the best option. But most games have more than one player. Imagine this is a representation of a game you're playing, and there can be a number of moves. Say you have a function that evaluates how good the next positions are. If it's your turn, you would pick the one with the highest number. But an opponent would pick the one with the lowest number. These preferences give rise to the traditional names max and min. To see this in action, let's use an example. The game of Nim is played with matches arranged in bundles. Check out the rules in the video in the link. To see how strong play can be calculated, we need some graphics. Say the game starts with 7 matches, represented by this one number. Players can split one bundle into 2 different sized new bundles, and for this small game, we can draw the whole search base. We'll let the opponent, min, go first. That divides the space depending on whose turn it is. For ending positions, we use 0 for a loss by max and 1 for a win. Traditional game theory choices for expressing utility. All the intermediate positions then get their values by backing up the numbers from the leaves. Any position with just one move is simple. With more than one move, min will prefer the smallest of the options. But max chooses the largest. At the top, min has to pick a 1 on the first move. That tells us the game is a loss for the first player. The Minimax algorithm has found for us the game-theoretic value.